Yeah, in Northfield, we have kind of two models for the conversation going, and I've heard a couple, as people have talked about, I think it reflects it, but I wanted to point it out. One is the, and Tracy and Tim mentioned this, the where you put up a facility like a forum where anybody in your town can start a conversation, be it about a thing at City Hall or about where's your favorite coffee house or whatever it happens to be. And so in Northfield, we've had kind of that culture for quite a while. When the three of us formed our blog and our podcast, we wanted to be a little more directive about it. And I think Corey talked a little bit about this. So there's just the three of us that post to our blog and our co-hosts of the radio show. And so we really like the conversations on the topics that we start. And I think the psychology of that a little bit, and I've heard it here a couple times, is when you launch a blog post and then you want conversation about it, you're motivated to keep that conversation going, to moderate it, to make it turn into something interesting and influential, which is different than kind of convening a space where anybody and everybody can start conversations. So I think those two models are both viable. We see them all over the internet in place blogs as well as communities of interest. And I think for the people listening or watching, those are kind of, in my mind, the fundamental two directions you can go. In Northfield, we're lucky to have both. And I think for the three of us that are co-hosts of Locally Grown, we want them to be fun. We want it to be irreverent. You know, take a lesson from The Daily Show, and we write some fake news pieces for our town, like The Onion. And we have a lot of fun with it, but we wrap the important civic issues of the town into that mix, and then take responsibility to moderate each one of those conversations that happen to start. And we moderate them with a iron fist of civility, because we believe we want the leaders in town to participate in these conversations. And so we want to make sure that they're treated well when they join the conversations. And so we don't allow sarcasm, and we insist on, you know, people looking each other in the eye when they disagree, and we run a tight ship.
So what you're really doing is mixing that great challenge that traditional editors have always had of both leading and following public opinion, both providing the fluff and providing the meat, and mixing them in such a way that you keep the audience or you keep the participation alive.
Yeah, but I think what we tend to lead with is the conversation first. You know, we'll start a blog post by saying, hey, who showed up at City Hall last night? I didn't make it. There was kind of an interesting agenda. And so we'll lead with that. And so conversations will kind of coalesce around what happened at City Council meeting last night. And then people say, well, yeah, I better read that newspaper story about it. I'm interested in looking at the video of the council meeting now. So it's conversations as a way in rather than the school model of, well, first you read the chapter and then you talk about it. We're doing the reverse. Discuss it first, get your juices flowing, have the social element because these are people who are near you. Oh, and then, gee, I want to follow this up more with a link or a story or an article.